far as the 14th row. Hello there! We have been introduced. I'm Dame Bob. Oh, but I've had a hard life.
Ah.
Harder than that.
Ah.
I started out with nothing and I've still got most of it. All I ever wanted was a chance to prove that money can't bring you happiness. I was only married a year when I heard the patter of tiny feet.
The children?
No! The mice! Who were everywhere. Ate us out of house and home, they did. And then my husband left me.
Oh.
And it's a hard life bringing up two children all on your own. I'm forever working out how to make ends meet. And when I do, they move the ends.
Oh.
Their fortune never calls, just a daughter, miss. We live in such a rough neighbourhood of town too. They did put up a welcome sign once, but now it just says, well.
Oh.
The other night I was getting changed into my nightie and I caught a man peering through my bedroom window. Then bold as brass he came knocking on my front door.
What did he say?
He asked me to close the curtains. Cheek. I've tried everything to provide for those boys. I even tried being a contortionist, but I had to give that up.
Why was that?
I just couldn't make ends meet. I'm serious though, I've tried everything. I've asked for money, I've begged for money, I've cried for money, I've dreamed for money.
But have you ever tried working for money?
What's your cheek, you? I'm working my way through the alphabet and I haven't reached W yet. Oh, there you are! I need you to go down to the bazaar and get me a few things. I need a dozen lemons. That's for the Shahrazad's hair. She wants me to bleach it because someone told her blondes have more fun. I said, no, it was clowns that had more fun and she should get a big red nose. She didn't like it. Are you listening to me? Oh, I don't know. He lives in a dream sometimes, that boy. Oh, hello, Bob. Maybe you can help me wake Ellie up. He's gone into one of his trances again.
Morning, Dame Barbara. Don't worry. I'll soon snap him out of it.
I'm so glad Ali has a friend like Bob. He's so strong and reliable. Ali needs someone like that in his life. Goodness knows he won't get it from his father. If I ever catch hold of that Ali Barber Senior again, I'll give him a crimping. He won't forget. Sultan of shampoo and set, indeed.
So what with your husband then, Dame Barber?
Not a sausage. He was only going away to a crimping and firming conference the other side of the desert, and that was 5 years ago. I'm so miserable. It's almost like I've been in here. Excuse me!
Ali? Ali? He's forever in a dream world, you know. He goes like this every time he sees the Princess Jasmina. Can you keep a secret?
Yes.
You don't seem very sure. Can you keep a secret?
Yes.
Okay, I'll trust you. I'm a princess too. The Princess Modestasia. But Ali and the others just know me as Bob. I get so caught up in the palace. So, when I want some fun, I put on these old clothes and come down to the city to see my friends. They haven't a clue that I'm the Princess Jasmina's younger sister. I don't know what it is about her. I just wish Ali would notice me for once.
Oh, shit.
Any luck with Sleeping Beauty?
None, I'm afraid. But why is he like that?
Oh, it's that princess. He's besotted with her. He can't stop thinking about her. He's the only one that likes her, though. Far too bossy for her own boots and lazy. She doesn't even pick her own nose.
Oh. What does he see in her?
Oh, something about her singing. He hasn't got the brains he was born with. You'll have to help me wake him up. If we make a lot of noise, that might do it.
Oh, yeah. That's not loud enough.
Not working, is it?
No.
Try jumping.
Okay.
1, 2, 3. It's no good. Wonder if them lot will be any help.
I don't know.
Can you lot make a lot of noise?
Yeah.
I said, can you not make a lot of noise?
Yes!
That's better. Right. Well, maybe after three you could try shouting, wakey, wakey. Can you do that?
Yes!
Right then. After three, one, a two, three.
Wakey, wakey!
Yes, Your Highness, your wish is my command.
Good! Then you can go and get me some lemons.
What? Oh, you're not the princess.
Of course I'm not the princess. Do I look like a princess? On second thought, don't answer that. You've got to get her out of your head. She's way out of your league. You've got more chance of marrying Bob than Jasmina.
Beautiful.
And bossy. And grumpy.
And she sings like an angel.
What? Have you heard her?
I have. She sings like a cat with stomach aches.
No, you see, I climbed the wall of the palace once and heard her singing. I've been in love ever since.
You don't want to be doing that. You're into that wrong grand vizier. He's a nasty man. Obsessed with wealth and power. If this was a democracy, they'd have elected him prime minister. And if he catches you, you'll be caught and cut into thousands of tiny pieces. And I'll never be able to decorate a trifle again without thinking of my poor boy.
No. No, it's fine, Mum. You see, I have got a plan to see the princess again and talk to her. Because I've got a plan to get into the palace.
I'd best get back there and make sure he doesn't get into trouble.
Oh, goodness! Is this the time? I have to go and wash my socks. See you later.
He wasn't wearing any socks. So come on then, Brainbox. How do you plan on getting in the palace? Oh, no, I'm best not knowing, actually. If only your brother Sinbad was here, he'd sort you out.
Oh, hello. Has anybody seen my camel?
No.
Anyway, never mind that mangy beast for a moment. Come and help me sort your brother out. He's besotted with the princess.
He doesn't know anything about women.
Yes, I do. I was quite the ladies' man when I was at sea. I had a girl in every port. Or was that a port in every girl?
See what I mean?
I remember those days well. I sailed the high seas seeking out adventure. And then, one day, I was offered the chance to own my own ship. Oh, me! Imagine that! Me, captain of my own ship! I didn't know it was going to be a ship of the desert, though, did I? Now I'm lumbered with this useless camel. I mean, you can't ride it. You can't milk it. The only thing it's good for is eating, and it eats anything! It doesn't even turn its nose up at Mum's stew, and that's been used for laying foundations.
Cheap! You're as bad as each other, you two. Come on, there's work to be done.
No, Sinbad, come here. Look, we've got a plan. We're going to sneak in the back way of the palace, and then we can disguise ourselves.
Right, but first I'm going to find my camel. You will tell me if you see my camel, won't you, boys and girls?
Yes.
Oh.
Oh, I give up running round after that creature. I'm exhausted. He's not there. You're having me on.
There he is.
Where is that? Oh, it's there.
Not really what I expected at all.
No, get off. No, it's no use trying to butter me up. I've got the hump. Oh, you didn't like that one, did you? All right, try this one instead. What do you get if you cross a cow with a camel? Give up? Lumpy milkshake. Michael McIntyre's comedy roadshow, this is not. Oh, what's all this? case with a basket.
Hey!
What have you got there, little bro?
It's disguises! This is how we're going to get into the palace.
Ah, yes. Well, you remember how I said I'd help you get into the palace?
Yes.
Yeah, well, what I actually meant was I won't help you get into the palace.
Oh, come on! I simply must get into the palace so I can see the princess!
Oh, let's not and say we did!
What about your life of adventure?
Great idea, let's do that instead!
Have you no get up and go?
No, it got up and left. I'll go look for it.
But... Thanks, Humpy. Listen, Sinbad. When I marry the princess, I'll be rich and powerful. Just imagine what I'll be able to do for my friends.
Oh, that's nice. And what about your poor family?
And my family as well, you dingbat. What I mean is, you help me now, and I'll remember you later.
Oh, I don't know about that. The captain of my first ship said if I joined his crew, he'd remember me in his will.
And did he?
Well, sort of. When they read his will, it said, I remember Sinbad.
Oh, come on and help me find some disguises to get into the palace.
Wouldn't
it be
funny? Oh, I like that one. That was in my colour.
Boys, where are you, you lazy good for nothing snacks?
No!
Quick, tell them where we are.
Please.
I tell you, those boys you mentioned work and the hardest to find in that Whittaker's wasteland.
Princess Bubba stays here. Why the dim light? You should be happy. The weight of responsibility will soon be lifted from your shoulders when I...
How dare you enter without permission? You are not the ruler, and never will be if I can help it.
My dear, there are but a matter of days until your 21st birthday. And then, as tradition dictates, if you're not married before then, the city's rule becomes the responsibility of... the Grand Vizier! Ha 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 ha! Why so hostile? If you are so intent on keeping the throne, I believe I am free to get married on your special day. Together, we can rule Arabia.
She'll never marry you.
And why not? Am I not everything a bride could wish for? I have wealth, status, rugged good looks.
Bad breath.
Terrible dress sense.
Old age.
Enough. Good personality.
Enough! If you shall not wed me, I shall rule Arabia on my own.
Will you kindly leave my chambers and never bring those ugly brutes in here again?
Who? These? I never go anywhere without my leaked bodyguard, my henchman.
Weak and a bear, kill in the sack, au revoir, my de mer.
Henchman, not Frenchman, you fools.
Can you trust those two to guard your body?
Brains aren't everything.
Well, in their case, they are nothing.
I shall have the last laugh, princess, in 3 days' time, when I take the throne.
Oh, isn't It's amazing how a man like that can bring happiness and joy to a room just by leaving it.
We shouldn't upset him like that, you know. He could make life very difficult for us.
Like it isn't difficult already. As princess, I have no real power. As a royal, I have no real freedom. Oh. And as a member of the Arabian Book Club, I get no choice to my book of the month.
So why do you want to be ruler? You won't get any more freedom.
Why not? When I am in charge,
tradition says that.
Tradition can whistle for all I care. When I rule, I will change the rules. I will go where I please, when I please, with whom I please. And right now, what pleases me is entertainment.
Play us something funky.
The recorder.
We can give it a try.
Give it a try.
Go on.
Problem can be found in
God! There's an intruder!
Quick! You must escape!
you again. Guards! Yes. Go into the town and find those intruders. Now move. You shall never be ruler. I shall see to that. Nya!
Oh, thank goodness they've all gone. It's beginning to smell in here.
I thought those two from the town were quite nice.
No, they're just commoners.
But you like Ali.
Oh, don't talk nonsense. I only want to marry him so I can become ruler. And when I am ruler, I can do as I please while he does all the boring stuff.
Well, that's a bit harsh.
Oh, for heaven's sake, sister. You're the soppy one, remember?
Well, harsh or not, you're going to get nowhere if we don't warn Ali about the vizier's plans.
You're right. How do we warn him about the plan? What is the plan, anyway? How do we get past the guards? Princesses can't just leave the palace at the drop of a hat.
Don't worry, sister. I'll get a message to him somehow. I have my methods.
Oh, what's the point? Ali's never going to become a prince, anyway.
I think I can help you there as well. I've heard stories of a magical ruby hidden away in the desert. The ruby can transform its owner into anything that is wished for, including a prince. If Ali could find it, all your troubles would be over.
I knew I could count on you.
Right. Now, to disguise myself as Bob, slip past the vizier's guards, deliver a message to Sinbad, warn Ali, return to the palace, slip past the guards, change into my princess's robes, and back in time for hot chocolate. All in a day's work for the youngest princess in the kingdom.
In the Navy, sailor. Several seas in the Navy. You can live a life of ease in the Navy. Oh, you can fill your shoes with cheese in the Navy. In the Navy. Oh, hello again. Has anyone seen my camel?
No.
Where is that wretched thing? Soon as I got back from the palace, Mum told me that Humpy had run away into the desert, and I've been looking for him ever since. That flea-bitten beast has had me out here for hours, under the hot sun, with no food, no water.
Aww.
Sad of man.
Aww.
Ship of the desert? Oh, I wish I was on a ship. Instead of in here, in this rotten place, I'd give anything to be a sailor again. Well, at least then I'd have water. Water.
Water.
Mirror yourself. Aha! The cave! It has been too long, but soon the power will be mine. Now I will rule this miserable kingdom. Well, it's not miserable yet, but it will be when I've finished with it. First Arabia, then Bispham! Yes, how do you like that? Shh! The sands of time blow right and left. I wish to enter twixt your cleft. I say these words of mystery and command you, open sesame! No! It works! Woo-hoo-hoo-hoo! Yes! Ha 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 ha.
I must be more fevered than I thought. I'm starting to see things. Mirages.
Still,
that was amazing, though. I must tell someone about it. On the other hand, who'd believe me?
Sinbad? Sinbad? Has anybody seen him?
Not you.
No. Where's he?
He's behind you.
up to something. If he tries to get back into the palace again, he'll be caught for sure. And all for nothing. Princess Jasmina doesn't even like him. He won't give up.
I know. He's very strong-willed when he sets his mind to something.
How long have you known?
Well, ever since we used to share a bed together as small boys. I mean, me, twice his size, always ended up with no covers. I mean, sometimes it was...
How long have you known that Princess Jasmina doesn't like him?
Well...
Yeah, come on!
Well, from the start, really. I mean, everyone knows that the Princess Jasmina only thinks of herself. You'd be surprised how much as normal folk know.
Does Ali know?
Ali? No. Daft as a brush. The only thing he thinks about is Princess Jasmina. Everything else escapes him. You know that saying how some people have drunk from the fountain of knowledge? Well, Ali only gargled.
You really like him, don't you?
Yeah. He's all right for me, you know.
Right, yeah.
Sinbad! Sinbad!
Has anyone seen Sinbad?
Oh,
no, he isn't!
Oh, yes, he is!
Tracy and me have been trained by the finest hairdresser in the land, Ali Barber.
And we're here to see that you've got the finest, bounciest barnet in the whole of Baghdad.
And how exactly is hair being worn this season?
Curlies. Short.
What a team. So I need straight, curly, long, short style.
Yes.
Oh, get out!
Come along, Tracy. I really don't think this is a good idea, you know. But I must see her again. But what if you're caught? You'll be for it.
It'll be worth it just to be near her again. How do I look?
Well, you look lovely, I suppose.
This costume's really tight. Are you sure it's supposed to be this tight?
Oh, yes.
But it's dangerous, honey. Come back!
I know how much you dread the idea.
You will not be so smug when I am ruler. I intend to marry before my 21st birthday.
Even if you were allowed out of the palace, no one will marry you now.
We shall see. I am not without suitors.
Ah, yes, the peasant boy Ali. Yes, princess, I know all about your little plan, but I'm afraid it will come to nothing. But enough of this banter. I wish to see dancing!
can make my more fortune as a magician, you know. Put them on stage and say they just do this work and poof, they disappear. I thought there'd be some comfort to me in my old age, what with my hopeless husband gone. But nope, just caused me more worry than ever. Take that Sinbad, he was out last week all night. When he came here the following morning, he looked ever so ill. I was going to give him the ticking off of his life. But then he told me for a bet he'd eaten a firework. So we let him off. And now they're both missing. And I've got the salon to clean, the floors to do. And this book has got a hole in it. I'd best get another one.
Thank you.
What are you moping for, lad? I'm sure you wanted adventure and excitement. Well, now you have some!
This isn't what I had in mind.
Allow me to introduce to you my special secret enchanted cave. Da-da-da-da. No, nothing. See that wonderful ruby over there? That is the source of all my power. However, I'm not an unfair man, and I'm willing to give it away to anyone that wants it. Step forward, all those that would like the ruby.
Oh,
dear. So sorry, my boy. I'll only keep you here maybe 60, 70 years. The first 20 will be the hardest. Then I think you'll find the time just slips by.
My friends will come looking for me, and when they get here, we'll make you pay.
Oh, no! Not your friends!
Yeah.
You mean that sozzled sailor and his damp fish companion? They're no match for my magical defences.
Magical defences? What are they?
Only the finest that money can buy. Picture this. An army of zombie warriors and the most gruesome, fearsome genie you've ever seen. If your friends can get past those, then maybe I'll have something to worry about. Farewell, Ali. I'll feed you once a week, and there's an almost endless supply of informational leaflets on local arts and crafts for you to read in case you get bored. Forgot to mention, the cave is alarmed, so no sudden movements. If the alarm goes off, so do the zombie warriors!
They need to cry with the Now, if one of you wouldn't mind unchaining me, I'm sure I've interrupted quite enough in your rehearsal.
I know. I'm a captive audience.
And you've got 300 more to show me!
Will I survive the zombies and escape the vizier's clutches? If he does, will he ever get over his thing about wearing women's clothing? Will the vizier get the power he desires? Will Jasmina get married in time? Will Bob ever reveal herself to Ali? Tune in for Act 2 after the break and find out.
Go! Oh. Yes! wretched items, you idiots. There isn't an ocean for hundreds of miles.
Well, maybe you were thinking of opening a seafood restaurant, sir.
Yes, that's it. Oh! Look, just take this woman and help her with her washing or something. I need to lie down.
That's right. You two get scrubbing. I've got a boy to save. But first, I need to get tooled up.
I see.
anything else?
Yes, I also found a sandcastle, a sand dune, a sandal, a sandwich, and Sandra Bullock.
Did you find anything not made from sand?
Yes, I came across a magnificent garden with tables laden with exotic fruits and wines, which were all so beautiful to behold. But the strangest thing is that they all tasted exactly like
sand.
You've been there, haven't you?
No, but talking to you, I'm feeling the same sensation. You were hallucinating, weren't you? That's the answer. If we can make you feel the same way, maybe you'll remember where the vizier went and what he said.
You mean it was just the mirage?
Yes.
Well, that does explain why those melons were so gritty.
Oh, dear. Right, there's no time to lose. We have to make you get hot, real hot.
Could I get any hotter, baby?
Well, yes. Yeah, quite frankly. You wait there. I'll be back in a minute. Actually, just jog up and down a bit to start with. That should get you warmed up nicely.
Are you sure this is a good idea?
Yes. Now hop to it. Left, right, hop, 2, 3, 4.
It's working. Definitely getting hotter.
But we have to make it get so hot you start seeing things.
Put it inside out now. Shining the outside. Oh, not the same thing. Oh, it's working. It's all starting to come back to me now. I can hear. Music. Where's the start?
Ali?
Fred!
Come on!
We should split up! We can do much more damage that way!
You're right, though. The sludge case. You search that end, and I'll search this.
Great idea! Shout if you find anything!
Ali? Ali! If something's happened to him, I'll never forgive myself! Ali! Oh no! We are too late! And now he's dead! Oh, Ali! I wish I could have told you everything! How I pretended to be a boy to hang around with you! How I wish that you'd love me instead of my bossy sister! And now...
Meet a man again. The romance, the dancing, the muscles.
me, isn't she?
Is it just me, or is this Jane more demure than demonic?
I don't care if she's a big softy. You go hard with her if she lays one finger on her. Oi! You're hitting on the men I love. Well, hang around with a lot.
What little me?
You heard Jane talk. Well, I need a man.
Is the spell broken?
Yes.
continent. Shelter. Sunblock, anything. Just help me, Opie. I said sunblock, not a sunfrock. For heaven's sake, come be fetch someone to save me. Anybody, please. Blimey, that was quick.
Goodness, you don't usually see beach dwellers this far from the sea.
How many rude? I'll have you know I've been on a crash diet.
Well, you do look a bit of a wreck.
Wendy, you were slap if I wasn't so weak.
What are you doing in the middle of the desert without protection? You can make yourself poorly, don't you know?
I'm already poorly. I'm putting sick for my two boys, you see. They're missing, and I'm here to find them and bring them home.
Two boys, eh? What did they look like? Were they handsome with rippling muscles and bronzed hands? Boyish good looks with manly charms, rugged yet soft.
Well, one of them is, and the other one is a bit, well, let's both to say they're a bit, You see, the younger one looks like this fella. His elder brother looks a bit like this fellow, and they'll probably have a friend with them that looks a bit like this fellow. Have you seen them?
Who? The younger fellow that looks like this chap. The older fellow that looks like this chap. And their friend that looks like this.
No, I said the younger fellow that looks like this chap. His elder brother that looks like this chap. And their friend that looks a bit like this chap.
It's us! Can't say that I have no.
Shame! Mom! It's them! My boys! I've been so worried! Come to Mummy! Blinding your mother like that! Have a good night!
Miss Farmer, we have to get to the palace so Ali can claim his prize! Time is running out!
Jeannie, can you work your magic?
Not if you want to make young Ali here into a prince, Popeye. I didn't think I'd be using the ruby anytime soon, so it's not fully charged.
Oh, how else can we get to the palace quickly?
Oh, feet!
No, that's not going to work.
I know! Humpy can carry us all on his back!
Yeah!
perhaps not.
Time's a-wasting, folks. To the palace. And I hope those guards have been working out.
Is it?
It's a genie, three young men, a fat lady, and a camel.
What? Where?
Over there, by the sundune. There.
I can't see anything.
Strain your eyes, look. Over there, by the sundune.
Speeches. You'll be there. After all, somebody has to do it. Face it! You've lost! Ali's not coming and the kingdom is mine. You're resigned to a life of waving and ribbon cutting. Just sit back, relax, watch me gloat some more. Yes! Yes!
Ladies and gentlemen, weighing in at 150. The Prince of Power, the Sultan of Sovereignty, the Emir of Eligibility, and the Viscount of Vacant Stairs.
It can't be it!
Ow! All right. The one, the only, Ali Baba.
You! But how? Why? And when?
Ali, you're here.
Hello.
But you're no different. Aren't you supposed to be a prince?
Oh, no, I almost forgot. Genie, make me a prince.
Well, there, Neddy, it's not quite that simple.
What do you mean?
Well, the ruby works in two ways. If you make a wish for your own benefit, there's a very important side effect.
Like?
Well, your wish will be granted, but because your wish was a greedy one, you'll be called totally evil. Hell-bent on destruction and will suffer nothing short of world domination. Where do you think Turbantop got his sparkling personality from?
Hang on,
you'll get your chance shortly. What you can do is wish good things for other people. An unselfish wish works with no troubles at all.
So I can't turn myself into a prince without becoming evil?
Yes.
No, but I can.
Oh, you'd wish that for me?
Ali, you're my best friend. I only have wanted you to be happy. Genie, cast that spell.
Ali Baba, your majesty.
So fast.
From this moment,
It's almost perfect, dear princess. Sing to me. I need to hear your silken tones again.
If you insist. No!
Only dogs can hear that last note. No, not that one. The other softer tune.
I don't do any other bit. Anyway,
no, the one that goes, say my name, sun shines through the rain.
I don't sing that dreadful battle. That's my sister's favourite tune.
I think there's been a terrible mistake.
Whatever, anyway. Look, when we're married, I've compiled a list of your duties. I realise that it's quite long. But in all honesty, I'm planning on being away quite a lot. Diplomatic visits to other countries and the like.
But you want me to do what? You want me to go to a boys' own concert? Oh, that's worse than her singing. You want me to do charity work at Preston North End? You do realise we lost again today. Hang on. You want me to reopen the promenade? Will that ever happen?
No!
The voice! The beautiful singing voice that I fell in love with. Where is it gone?
Do you not want to marry the princess now, Al?
The voice! Who had the wonderful voice?
Oh, the holy man!
And God!
I stop everything! Oh, I can't keep the secret no longer! Manuel thought I was.
Yes? And then what happens?
You don't see.
Uh-uh.
Hang on.
Oh, Princess Bulbastasia! It's you! But she was a he was a she! She, he, oh!
Oh, I love you! And I've been pretending to be well, just to be close to you. I'm sorry, everybody, for fooling you this way.
We knew.
What?
We knew you, the princess. Well, some of us, anyway.
I didn't. Ellie, you're not exactly the brightest grain in the box, are you, dear? Even at school, you're a bit of a failure.
Oh, I'll have you know, I was the school swat.
Really? And how many exams did you pass?
Well, none. But I did kill a lot of flies.
How did you know I was the princess? Did I not make a convincing boy?
You did, your majesty.
Could I not climb trees fast enough? Did I not know most of the teams in the Arabian Cup?
Yes.
Did I not wait standing up?
Your highness, it was none of those things that gave you away.
So how did you know?
Well, some of the guards came down from the palace and threatened to beat us up if we didn't play along. Oh. And you seem like quite a lot, so we never let on. It does explain why you won those fights with those other gangs, though.
Excuse me! We're trying to have a wedding here! He doesn't want to marry you, sis. I'm sorry.
At last! I win!
Be quiet! You'll get your turn shortly.
Princess, is it true that all you seek is a life of adventure?
Yes. I needed to become ruler to protect Baghdad from the vizier and to make sure that Bob would be okay. But I never really wanted to rule.
A girl that likes adventure.
And can own her own ship. Yes.
That's the very kind of girl for me. Ali, I've got an idea. It is as hot as my sailor suit.
Okay.
Okay. All right, yeah. Okay. Jeannie. Make my brother a prince!
Now you're getting it!
Princess, marry me and together we shall see the world!
But what about the king?
me, may I?
You can have a turn now.
Whilst you lots were bickering about, the sound has run out of the timer. You're too late. I win. Swish, swish. Keep your paper. Pixie pickles for you.
I don't think so.
No. Well, time or not, you will never rule. Guards, kill them all.
Genie, get rid of the guards.
Can't do that, lady boy. If you wish for that, you'll benefit from it. You'll turn evil. Them's the rules. You're on your own now.
Step aside, boys. My turn to interfere.
Six heads or only five? To be honest, in all the excitement, I've kind of forgotten myself. So you have to ask yourself a question. Do you feel lucky? Well, do you, punk?
I surrender!
Hooray! Good! This arm's killing me!
Well done, Dave Barber!
Suckers! Ha ha! Now I have a roomie!
No!
No! The ruby!
Smash it to a million pieces!
Ah! What's happening to me?
The ruby turned him into the evil man that he was. Now it's destroyed. He's reverted back to his old self.
I'll get you, my pretty. I'm going to knock you!
Well, the grandma's here is really the wicked witch of the west.
Yes, no, it's not. She must have used the ruby to wish at some point.
Would have got away with it too if it wasn't for those mental kids.
He's old Mr. Jones, the full fair caretaker.
Luke! You failed me! For the last time!
Is that it?
No! I'm melting! Melting!
Well, that sorted that out. Things Bob and I will be together. As will Bob and Ally. And now that the ruby's destroyed, I'm free! Free!
What will you do, Jeannie?
Well, I've had my eye on for some time now, and I reckon I could do well as the managers for the Zombie World Dance Warriors.
You think you've got what it takes to make a successful act?
Not really, but imagine how many men I'll meet in the entertainment teams.
Fair enough.
What about me? Where's my happy ending? However will I get these stains out of my mental wounds? Oh, hello, dear.
Wait a minute. I know that voice. It's my husband, Ali Barber Sr. The baddest hairdresser in all of Baghdad. The Caliph of Crimping. The Sultan and Chef of Shampoo. All Camel Arabian Birmingham champion 3 years on the trot. The one, the only, Tammy!
Oh, hello, lads. Lovely to see you.
What happened to you? We thought we'd lost you at a Crimping and Birmingham conference in the desert.
Well, I was out frolicking in the fields and I found this rather pretty ruby and thought to myself, you know what, I could do with some new threads. So I made a wish and shazam, I became the vizier. Oh. Did you miss me?
Yes,
But you don't
think
I'm going to anymore! Come on!
Celebration, then. All is well. Let us have a proclamation. I want the whole town here for the news.
Hurrah!
worried, though.
Why?
About the wedding night.
Hang on, the wedding night? Mm. There are kids in this audience.
Oh,
be careful.
No, about the wedding dance.
Oh!
Not too sure I know all the moves.
Oh, the proper wedding dance. Yeah. I know, I'm a bit worried too. We're going to have to practice, aren't we?
I do. I don't think we can do it on our own, though.
No, neither do I.
I think we need some help.
I think we do. Do you think you lot out there can help us practice our proper wedding dance?
Yeah.
I think we'll try that again. Do you think you can help us?
Yes!
I think we need some volunteers.
Yes, you've got to get some volunteers and I'll explain. So it's about a king called Caractacus from somewhere up north, a very important king, and he's having a parade. And it was sung by a very famous snake charmer called Rod Paris. So it should be a bit of fun anyway. But there are specific actions we must learn. Hello. Would you like to come up and help us?
I'm losing people here. Okay. I'm looking the other way.
Hello. And what is your name? Daniel, how old are you?
Ten.
Ten? Ten. One?
No.
Kids? No. You've still got time, don't worry. Come on. Come and help us. It's a good dance and you can show your legs. Come on. It's either that or we get out of
this.
You go and talk. I'm going to come and get some.
Come on.
Come on. You go and find another. So hello, what's your name?
Rob.
Rob, and how old are you, Rob?
You don't want to know.
Yeah, I don't want to know. We're going to learn a dance. Hello, and what's your name? Victoria, and how old are you?
Nine.
You're nine. Now, do you have a husband?
No.
Oh, not doing very well so far.
No, that's more than one.
Who are you?
Sue.
Sue, and how old are you, Sue?
25.
25, yay! And hello.
Hi, you want me a drink?
I know, I do. We'll talk about that later. And what's your name?
I'm Claire.
Claire! And how old are you, Claire? I'd say 10.
Ten.
Good. Okay, right. Now we're going to learn the moves. Now you can sit down to learn it, but then you're all going to stand up.
Yeah,
right. Down there. Okay. Go sing that.
Right, so this dance is all about some ladies in a parade. So we're going to do the first thing four times just so you get used to it. And then we're going to show you the next bits twice. Okay? You're all going to join in with me. Okay, so it's the ladies.
The ladies.
Of the harem.
Of the harem.
Of the court.
Of the court.
Of King Caractacus.
Of King Caractacus.
We're just passing by.
Are
you ready?
Again.
The ladies.
Of the harem.
Of the court. Of King Caractacus.
King Caractacus.
We're just passing by.
We'll do it another time.
The ladies.
Of the harem.
Of the court.
Of King Caractacus.
We're just passing by.
Last time.
The ladies.
Of the harem.
Of the court. Of King Caractacus.
We're just passing by.
Oh, very well done.
Thank you. So far. Unfortunately, it gets more complicated. Okay, everything builds on that, but we're only going to do the rest two times. So, it's not the first thing you notice about the ladies. It is the noses
on the faces
of the ladies
of the harem
of the court of King Caractacus.
We're just passing by.
Okay, one more time. Practicing this one. Noses.
Noses
on the faces. Of the ladies,
of the harem,
of the court of King Caractacus.
We're just passing by.
Oh, do you sing that? They're doing really well so far.
Right, these ladies, shiny noses. So what do they need?
Okay.
They need the boys.
Boys.
We put the powder.
On the noses.
On the noses.
Of the faces.
Of the ladies.
Of the harem.
Of the court of King Caractacus.
We're just passing by.
Fabulous.
Boys.
The boys.
Put the powder.
On the noses.
Of the faces,
of the ladies,
of the harem,
of the court of King Caractacus,
we're just passing by.
So well.
Okay, now this is the last bit.
Okay.
Right, all working their own.
No,
there's more. So, the boys have the fascinating witches who put the scintillating stitches in the britches
of the boys,
who put the powder
on the noses,
of the faces,
of the ladies,
of the harem,
of the court of King Caractacus.
We're just passing by. Okay, one more time. The fascinating witches
who put the scintillating stitches
in the breeches
of the boys
who put the powder
on the noses,
of the faces,
of the ladies,
of the harem,
of the court of King Caractacus.
We're just passing by.
Oh, I'm so impressed.
you. Oh, come on.
Right. Okay, so you can see now, how slides are. Right.
There's a slide.
Okay, are we ready? I will warn you, it is slightly faster than what you just done, but you'll be fine. All right. Maestro, music, please!
Now the ladies of the harem of the court of King Caractacus were just passing by. Now the ladies of the harem of the court of King Caractacus were just passing by. Now the ladies of the harem of the court of King Caractacus were just passing by. Now the ladies of the harem of the court of King Caractacus were just passing by. Now the noses on the faces of the ladies of the harem of the court of King Caractacus were just passing by. Now the noses on the faces of the ladies of the harem of the court of King Caractacus were just passing by. Now the noses on the faces of the ladies of the harem of the court of King Caractacus were just passing by. Now the noses on the faces of the ladies of the harem of the court of King Caractacus were just passing by. Now the boys put the power on the noses of the faces of the ladies of the harem of the court of King Caractacus were just passing by.
Thank you. Yeah.